Hello, and welcome to this video on uploading storage resources to an Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager storage domain. In this video, you will learn to list the prerequisites and supported disk image types for uploading to a storage domain, describe the requirements for uploading image files to storage domains, demonstrate the steps for uploading virtual machine image files using the Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager administration portal. Virtual disk images are attached to virtual machines as data disks. Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager supports QEMU or Quick Emulator compatible disk image types, or any disk image format supported by the QEMU emulator. These disk image types can be either the QCOW2 or QEMU copy on write format or a raw image, but the QCOW2 image format is the most versatile as it delays the allocation of data storage until it is needed. Copy-on-write support means changes made to the disk image are only a representation of the actual changes to the disk. It uses small file sizes on the file system, even on sparse files, and supports multiple VM snapshots, AES encryption, and zlib-based compression. Raw disk image files only contain the raw disk data without a specific format. However, it does have the advantage of being easily exported. ISO image files are attached to virtual machines as CD-ROM players for booting. To successfully upload images, the Image.io proxy service must be running. This service is configured and started when you run the engine setup utility during the installation of the manager. The engine setup utility installs a certificate authority into the web browser used to access the administration portal, which in turn enables the upload task. Before the upload process starts, you must successfully test the connection to the overt-imageio-proxy service. So let's now see how to upload an ISO image to data storage that's already been created. After logging into the Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager administration portal, we're brought to the dashboard screen. From the menu options, we go to Storage and select Disks. This gives us a list of currently configured disks. To upload a resource, we click the drop-down on the Upload button and then select Start from the drop-down list. We click the Choose File button and search our local machine for the ISO file we want to upload. In this case, the ISO file I want is an Oracle Linux 7.7 disk image. I keep the default selections in the Disk Options fields. We could change the data center, storage domain, and host to use, but for now we will leave them as they are. If you would like more information about these fields, you can refer to the Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager documentation. A link is provided to it at the end of this video. Remember, to upload images, the Image.io proxy service must be running. So first, we test the connection to it before starting an upload. We click the Test Connection button to verify the connection to overt-imageio-proxy is working. This verification test must be successful before you can proceed. The test passed, so we click OK to begin the upload. The file now appears in the alias column of the list of disks. Note that currently we have the All tab selected, which shows all uploaded disk types. Currently, ours has a status of lock, but the status transitions to transferring from browser and then to showing the number of megabytes sent with a bar indicating the status of the upload. You can pause, cancel, or resume uploads at any time by clicking on the Upload button and choosing from the drop-down menu. After the upload completes successfully, the status shows complete and the image is ready for use by virtual machines. After watching this video, you should be able to list the prerequisites and supported disk image types for uploading to a storage domain, describe the requirements for uploading image files to storage domains, demonstrate the steps for uploading virtual machine image files using the Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager administration portal. Oracle provides an extensive number of resources which you can use to find out more about this subject and others. You can find documentation on Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager at the link shown. There is a comprehensive Oracle Linux curriculum available to support a full range of Linux administration skills for cloud, on-premise, and hybrid users. For more information or to get started on Oracle Cloud Infrastructure, go to cloud.oracle.com. And for more training on Linux on Oracle Cloud Infrastructure, go to the link shown here. That's the end of the video. Thanks for watching.